Doctor Who Spearhead from Space. Episode 1. Unit Tracking Station. On Earth, a bored, sweaty, uniformed radio operative sees a line of dots appear on his screen. He grabs the internal telephone. Technician, duty office. Sir, please, urgent. A woman in the same uniform enters. Officer, what is it? Technician, I've got something on here, madam. Something strange. Officer, are you sure it's not just interference? Something to do with the heat wave. Technician, no, madam. There's something on there. Officer, scan closer. Stay very still, very high. Technician, coming down fast, though, madam. And heading this way, technician. Officer, there must be meteorites. Technician, but they're flying in formation. Vapor trails in formation has formed into the atmosphere. In Oakley Woods, a poacher is concealing a snare trap. He looks up to see a group of very artificial objects whistling down towards him. He dives for cover. Boom. Technician, they've come down. Officer, where? Technician, Sector 5, Epping. Officer, bearing? Technician, just working it out, you know. I still think it's a formation, madam. There was a shape. The poacher used a stick to prop at the smoking area where the object landed. He reveals a pulsating light under a layer of steaming hot soil. He covers it up again. Officer, control have reported that meteorite storm to the unit HQ. Technician, so control didn't think they were meteorites either. Officer, what else could they be? Don't let your imagination run away with you. Technician, I suppose it must have been meteorites, mustn't they? A TARDIS materializes in Oakley Woods. Door opens and a grey-haired figure falls face down into the heather. Brigadier's office. A woman in a red hair, with red hair, a tight bun, is chauffeured through an underground area far past a checkpoint. The office is at the end of the corridor with a vent ducking along it. Brigadier, yes. Ask her to come in. He greets the woman at the door. Brigadier? Ah, good, Miss Shaw. I am Lipperbridge Stewart. Do come in and sit down, will you? Liz. Was all that nonsense out there really necessary? Identity passes? Guards? I was even searched, Brigadier. Security, rather amusing. Don't you think? No, you didn't. Don't. Liz. I have an important research program going ahead at Cambridge. Brigadier, yes, I know, an expert in meteorites. Degrees in medicine, physics, and dozen other subjects. Just the sort of all-rounder I've been looking for. Liz? How I feel doesn't matter. Brigadier, we need your help, Miss Shaw. Liz, I'm just not interested in security work. Brigadier, security work? Liz, producing invisible ink. That sort of thing. Brigadier, we're not exactly spies here at the unit. Liz, then what do you do exactly? Brigadier, we deal with the odd, the unexplained, anything on Earth or even beyond. Liz, alien invaders, little blue men with three heads. Brigadier, 10 tons of alien material drift through space and land on this planet every day. Liz, and they are no harm to anyone. Brigadier, early this morning, a shower of about 50 meteorites landed in Essex. Liz, landed? Most meteorites don't even reach the Earth's surface. They usually burn up in the atmosphere. Brigadier, these didn't. The particular meteorites came down from a funnel of thin, superheated air, about 20 miles in diameter, for which no one has an explanation. Liz, there must be an explanation, a natural one. Brigadier, I hope so. We didn't find one last time. Liz, last time? Brigadier, 6 months ago, a smaller shower of meteorites, about 5 or 6 landed in the same area. Liz, no, that's impossible. The odds against the 2 lots of meteorites landing in exactly the same place must be incredible. Brigadier, they are, Miss Shaw, they are. Ashridge Cottage Hospital. A unit officer is with the doctor as a man is carried on a stretcher. Henderson, you have no idea who he is? Moreau. Not a clue. We found him unconscious beside a police box, of all things. Henderson. In the middle of the woods? Moreau, yes, we thought he was dead at first. Henderson, you see. Well, I better go and have a look at him. Brigadier's office. Brigadier, figures from the Institute of Space Studies, Baltimore. Do you realize that in this sector, galaxy, there are over 500 planets capable of supporting life? Liz, why is Earth any more likely to be attacked now than during the last 50,000 years? Brigadier, in the last decade, we've been sending probes deeper and deeper into space. We've drawn attention to ourselves, Miss Shaw. Liz, aren't you being a bit alarmist? Brigadier, since the unit was formed, there have been two attempts to invade this planet. Liz, really? Brigadier, we're lucky enough to be able to stop them. There was a policy decision. Policy decision, not to inform the public. Liz, do you seriously expect me to believe that? Brigadier, it's not my habit to tell lies, Miss Shaw. Liz, I'm sure, but it is a fantastic story. Brigadier, we are very lucky on both occasions. We had help from a scientist with great experience of other life forms. Liz, really? Who was this genius? Brigadier, well, it's rather difficult to explain. You used to call him the doctor. Phone buzzes. Brigadier, yes? Ashbridge Cottage Hospital. Colonel Moreau is putting in using the public payphone. Moreau here, sir. I'm in Ashbridge Cottage Hospital. Brigadier's phone office. Brigadier, what the dickens are you doing there? Have you found any of those meteorites? Ashbridge Cottage Hospital. Moreau, no, sir. All you found is a unconscious civvy. Brigadier, well? Moreau, he's lying beside a police box, abandoned by the look of it. Right in the middle of Oxley Wood. Brigadier's office. Brigadier, police box? Moreau, his man you found. Moreau, OC, he's here at the hospital, sir, undergoing treatment. Brigadier, OC, has he said anything? Moreau, OC, no, sir, not a syllable. He's out to the well wide. Brigadier, listen, Moreau. I want you an armed guard and put a police book at once. Police box at once. Nobody's to be allowed near it. Do you understand? Nobody. Ashbridge Control Cottage Hospital. Moreau, a guard, sir? Very well, sir. Do you want the police told, sir, about the police box? They may want it back. Brigadier's office. Brigadier, no account. I'm coming down immediately. In the meantime, carry on with the search. Ashbridge Cottage Hospital ward. A nurse puts an x-ray in the light box for the doctor's Henderson to see. Nurse ready, sir? Henderson. Thank you, nurse. Is this somebody's idea of a joke? Henderson, nurse, sir? Henderson, look at that. Nurse's heart, sir. Henderson. Yeah. If that is his heart. Nurse, what is this? Nurse, I don't know, sir. Henderson, someone in the x-ray is having a game. You stay with the patient, I'll find out who the fool is. Ashbridge Cottage Hospital Hotel Corridor. Henderson pushes past Mullins, the Welsh porter, blackening the carpet. His beeper goes off, he gets near an internal telephone, so he picks up the handset and dials 0. Henderson here. He signals Muffins to turn off the vacuum cleaner. Henderson, Dr. Henderson here. You're calling me? Lomax, OC, Scottish. Look here, Henderson. What's the idea of playing stupid tricks, Henderson? Me playing tricks? Who is that? Is that? Lomax, OC, Dr. Lomax, Perth Lab. You send out a blood sample of cross-matching. Henderson, yes, that's right. Just routine. Lomax, OC, listen, Henderson. I will not tolerate stupid practical jokes. If it wasn't human blood, you know it. Henderson, what do you mean, not human blood? I took it from the patient myself. Lomax, OC. It's not human blood type. The plantate sickness shows that Henderson. Are you there? Hello? Henderson, Dr. Lomax, I told you that blood sample was an adult male patient. Now tell me, is it not human blood? I don't know if that makes a doctor or a vet. It's still my job to look after him. Henderson puts the phone down and leaves. Ashbridge Cottage Hospital. Mullins goes to the public payphone. Mullins, oh hello, is that the Daily Chronicle? It is? Well look, my name's Mullins. I'm a porter at the Cottage Hospital in Ashbridge. I understand you pay for stories. You do? Well look, there's something very funny happening up here. Oxley Wood. A poacher has returned with a shovel and a stack. The ground has stopped smoking, and he digs up the pulsing beep, peeping one forked inanimate object. He puts it in his sack and then hears voices and goes in some nearby bushes. Forbes, OC, keep on your track. Unit soldiers are scanning the ground for detectors. Forbes, move over. Keep a straight line. Poacher returns it to his sack and leaves. Forbes, OC, have you got something there? Ashbridge Cottage Hospital ward. Patient is restless. He hangs over the side of his bed, looking underneath it. Nurse, what are you doing? Doctor, shoes. Must find my shoes. Doctor, no, you can't get up. Come on. Doctor, hand me, madam. Henderson, what's happening? Nurse, he's trying to get out of bed. Henderson, what? Nurse, he's unconscious again now. And he's still... We still haven't properly seen his face. Ashbridge Hospital, the Brigadier and Liz arrive in his staff collar, with a pendant fluttering from the bonnet. It's a press scrum in the reception area. Wagstaff, why can't we see him? Moreau, he's under medical care. Wagstaff, is that the real reason? What are you traps doing here? Moreau, I'm sorry, I can't answer questions. Wibble, why not? Is it a security order? Wagstaff, has it anything to do with those motorites? Moreau, I'm sorry, certainly nothing I can tell you. Man with very passive face is watching proceedings as the Brigadier and Liz enter. Mullins. Look, stand back there now. Stand back. Let him through. Wagstaff. Michael Wagstaff, defence correspondent on Daily Post. Reporter. Can you tell us anything, sir? Brigadier, what about? Wagstaff. What's unit doing here, sir? Is it true there's a man from space in there? Brigadier, nonsense. I don't know where you get these stories. Reporter. We heard there's something odd about him. Brigadier. I know nothing about a man from space, Wagstaff. That's why you are here, sir. Brigadier. Wait, Wagstaff, then why are you here, sir? Brigadier. For training exercise, Mullins. Stand back now. Let him through. Stand back now. Reporter, we have a visit. Has your visit any connection to the meteorites that fell last night? Is that why you cornered off the wood? Wagstaff, did the men who was brought in here find one of the meteorites? Reporter, was he injured by them? Wagstaff, are those meteorites dangerous? Brigadier, I'm sorry. I'll talk to you later then. Wagstaff, has he found it and then hidden it away, perhaps? Brigadier, if there's that story, you'll be given it later. At the moment, I have no comment to make. Money's all right. Come on, stand back now, boys. Oh, boys. Don't let you go. Can't let you go in there. It's more than my job's worth. Right now. Clear that away now. Wagstaff, I think I got to put a finger on it. A chap found one of those meteorites. I won't tell them where it is. Ashbridge Cottage Hospital corridor. Brigadier, how did you get onto this? Brigadier, how did that lot get onto this? Moreau, no idea, sir. It must have appeared as shadows in spring. It just appeared like swallows in spring. Brigadier, have you put the guard on the police box? Moreau, yes, sir. Two men with orders to keep strangers well away. Brigadier, oh, Moreau, see that you issue live admission, will you? And Moreau, live admission, but sir. Brigadier, that's an order, Captain. I'll see to it, sir. Brigadier, good. Moreau, I hold on here, sir. Brigadier, thank you. Ashbridge Cottage Hospital ward. We see our time traveller's face in his face as he sleeps peacefully. Welcome, John Petweet, to the show. Moreau, oh, Dr. Henderson, this is Brigadier Lethbridge Stewart and Liz, Elizabeth Shaw. Brigadier, well, how's your patient, Doctor? Can we see him? Henderson, well, you can see him, certainly. He's not making much sense yet, Brigadier. What? Still unconscious, huh? Henderson most of the time. His brief moments of consciousness had slipped back again. Liz, well, what's actually wrong with him? Henderson, I can't say. Never had a patient quite like him before. Liz, how do you mean? Henderson, well, his whole characteristical system is quite unlike anything I've ever seen. I told you, blood can't be identified. Brigadier, splendid. That sounds like the doctor. Brigadier goes to the bed and rolls a man to see his face. Liz, do you know him? Brigadier, what? No, I thought I might do. He's a complete stranger. I've never seen him before in my life. Dr. Wake's doctor. Leverage, Stuart. My dear fellow, how nice to see you again. Moreau, he knows you, sir. Brigadier, but he can't do. Look here. Can you hear me? Who are you? Doctor, don't you recognise me? Brigadier, I'm positive we've never met before. Doctor, it can't have changed that much, surely. I must see what they've done to me. Can I borrow a mirror, please? Liz hands over a compact mirror. Doctor, thank you. Oh, no. Well, that's not me at all. No wonder you don't recognise me. That face, that hair. Oh, I don't know, though. I think it's rather distinctive. Actually, don't you think? No, you don't. Oh, anyway, I'm tired. All this exertion. It's been too much. Have to get some sleep now. Brigadier, just wait, just a minute. Wake up, man. Listen to me, Henderson. I think that's quite enough for the moment. His mind's obviously disturbed. Anyway, I'm afraid he's out again. Brigadier, extraordinary business, Moreau. I want this man brought to London HQ. When he will be fit to travel. Brigadier, how difficult to say, Brigadier. I'd see. Well, as soon as possible, Moreau. In the meantime, carry on the search for those meteorites. Moreau, yes, very, very good, sir. Brigadier, is there another way out of here? I want to avoid the press if possible. Henderson, this way. Brigadier, thank you. Henderson and Brigadier and Liz leave. A doctor opens his eyes. Ashbridge Cottage Hospital. A car is heard driving away. Wagstaff has left Fridge Stewart. He must have nipped out the back way. Reporter, he's not going to tell us anything. Wagstaff, you know there's a story here, Jimmy. They're trying to cover something. Cover something. Reporter, Porter. When can we see the doctor, Henderson? Munnings, hey, look now. It's no good asking me. You have to wait. You just have to wait. So there. Wagstaff, I'm going to bring the office. The phone is occupied by the passive man. Wagstaff, who is this chap anyway? You've been hanging around for...
Sorry, I don't know who that is yet, but I learn about new people...
You've been around for ages. Let's do that bit again, sorry. Ashbridge Cottage Hospital. A car is heard driving outside. Wagstaff, Leverage Stewart. He must have nipped out the back way. Reporter, he's not going to tell us anything. Wagstaff, you know there's a story here. Jimmy is trying to cover something. Reporter, when can we see the Dr. Henderson? Mullins, hey, look now. It's no good asking me. You have to wait, so there. Wagstaff, I'm going to ring the office. But the phone is occupied with a massive, impressive man. Wagstaff, who is this chap anyway? Been hanging around for ages, reporter. I don't know. I've never seen him before. Wagstaff, did he tell you which paper he was on? Well, it's all him. No, he didn't tell me anything. He came in with the rest of you. I thought he was one of your law lot. Wagstaff, excuse me, sir? Are you going to be much longer? You see, we've got some stories to phone through. Well, you'd like to use the phone if possible. The man becomes alert, realizes the receiver's still on its cradle and leaves. Oxley Footwood, the poacher is approaching the alert unit soldiers. Selby, don't point those things at me, mister. Forbes, where do you think you're going? Selby, home. I belong in these parts, Forbes. How did you get into this wood? It's restricted, Selby. You fancy buying a rabbit too? Forbes, you're a poacher, are you? Selby, aren't you? Ain't nothing so tasty as fresh rabbit. A bit of salt and a few onions. Forbes, don't you see the patrols on the road? Shelby, but I reckon they never see me. Falls, all right, Dad. Get on your way. But don't come back until this wood is restricted. You understand, Shelby? The soldiers looking for them thunderbolts, huh? Falls, that's our business, Shelby. Reckon if I know where to find one of those things, it'd be worth a tiny bit or two, huh? Tiny old bit, huh? Forbes, you know where I landed? Silly, I didn't say that, did I, son? I was just asking. Forbes, yes, well, don't ask. Go on, push off. Ashbridge Cottage Hospital ward. Doctor, my shoes. Where are my shoes? Must find my shoes. The nurse is taking his pulse and tries to pull him back onto the bed. Doctor, I must find my shoes. Nurse, why? You don't need them. We're not going anywhere. Doctor, you don't understand, madam. Most important, Henderson. Who is this? How is he, nurse? Nurse, his pulse seems to have settled down. Sir, 10 minutes. Henderson, well, yes, well, the trouble is, we don't know what's normal for him, do we? Hello, how are you feeling? Doctor, shoes, Henderson. I beg your pardon? Doctor, shoes, nurse. It seems to be worrying him, sir. I think he believes they have been stolen. Henderson, well, if he wants them, he might as well. If he wants them, he might as well. Where are they, nurse? Nurse in his locker. Henderson takes a pair of black shiny shoes from the bedside locker. Henderson, are these what you're looking for? The doctor grabs them and rolls over, clutching the shoes to his chest. Henderson, I wonder if the brain's damaged. Nurse, he does seem to be behaving very rapidly. Henderson, fetch the sprig. Would you, nurse? I'll take his blood pressure again. While I'm here, Henderson sits at the table to make his notes. The doctor shakes his shoes and a key falls out. He puts his shoes under his pillow and lies down again. Henderson, thank you, nurse. Footsteps have entered. It's not the nurse. One man karate chop. Henderson, and another puts tape over the doctor's mouth. They knock him out, put him in a wheelchair, and head off down the corridors. Ashbridge Cottage Hospital corridor. A short while later, Henderson staggers along to be met by Moreau. Moreau, doctor, what's wrong? What's happened? Outside the hospital, an impassive man stands by ambulance. The two men are about to back the doctor onto it. When he grabs the wheel and heads it down the driveway, three men get to the ambulance and drive off just a row. A shot should come out. On the main entrance. Moreau, shoot the tires. Oxley Wood, gunshots are heard. Falls. There's something here. Something's happening. Outside the hospital. Moreau. Come on, this way. Running down the driveway. Moreau, Sergeant Harris. Cut across the main gate. Stop the ambulance. Stop the tires. Shoot the tires. The rest of you go around the back. Doctor sends his wheelchair down a crazy paving path. The soldier got in tires, cocked their weapons in the hotel grounds just past the prologue over there. The wheelchair's on its side, the figure's on a blanket. Moreau, there he is. But under the blanket's a pillow. Moreau, he got away. Just start searching. Oxley Wood, rustling in the shrubs. It is the doctor in the hospital gown with his mouth taped. Falls. Who's there? The second soldier shoots the doctor. Falls. Who told you to fire, you stupid? Doctor is once again face down in the heather.